All right, today I'll be presenting about the impact of 5G on mobile technology. Compared to previous mobile network advancements, how does 5G improve mobile devices? First, 5G vastly improves network speeds compared to previous mobile networks. A key reason for doing this is by reducing latency. Latency was often a big issue, especially with 4G, causing inconsistent network speeds. On the graph to the top right, as you can see, this shows the amount of latency going from 2G to 5G. Over each generation, as you can see, it's gradually decreased. But the key thing this graph emphasizes is how 5G has little to no latency, which will result in ultimate network speeds and create better efficiency. On the graph in the lower left, you can see the average download speed for 5G compared to 4G in multiple areas. As you can see, in each area, 5G beats 4G in download speeds, which shows how efficient the network speeds are from a global standpoint. Another big issue that 5G fixes is that it increases the amount of users that can access networks simultaneously. Often in the past, users would try to access networks in areas that consisted with a big population, so they would try to access networks at the same time. But 5G extends this issue by increasing network range and improving network speeds to provide for this ability. 5G also improves the amount you can download and stream. By doing this, this graph in the top right shows the data on how 5G does this. For a big movie such as E.T., in the past, this would usually take a couple of minutes or even up to hours, as you can see with 3G. But 5G has improved this by increasing the speed and also the gigabytes have lowered down, creating less space for the mobile user, which allows them to be able to download more movies that consist of the same amount or bigger files. 5G also increases network ranges. By doing this, they also create cell towers across multiple cities that, for example, would have buildings and trees, which would oftentimes cause network congestions. As you can see, the graph in the top right explains how the person, even though he's leaving his house, he's still receiving network through buildings and in places such as the streets. And this has also been tested by scientists as well, which shows the approximate range that 5G has for network range. Many would often state though that 5G struggles to help users receive data through buildings and trees, which has also been a big issue. But 5G does this by building cell towers in various cities that consist of a high population. As you can see in the graph here, this shows how the cell tower and how effective it is. As you can see, it shows the millimeters, millimeter waves, and it also shows the gigahertz that it has. And it also shows the coverage and capacity and the range that it consists. And they can give network to the use of devices in the near future because it fixes various issues and key issues compared to its predecessor. Thank you.
Okay. Let me get two questions for you.
Mm-hmm.
First question. Let's see. How valuable and reliable were the sources you used? And then how do you know they were? I don't know if you can hear me, but you're frozen right now.
Well,
can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now. You're good.
All right. For example, some of the sources, such as the ones that explain the network range, it shows the exact millihertz. And for example, also the sources that explain the amount of gigabytes that it takes for something to download. This explains, it lets the user know the amount and the speeds for how long these activities would take.
Okay. And what additional questions came up as you were doing the research?
One thing I would say is how to create an effective way to counter a problem that people would state. For example, the counterclaim slide that I had, I often had problems trying to figure out what could I use to counter it. But I found research and I researched that using the cell towers, it could improvise for the lack of coverage that 5G could have in the places, for example, with a lot of buildings and trees, and then places that would have a high population.